So now we will see forced commutation circuits. Forced commutation circuits means what is commutation, ma? So commutation nothing but we are turning on the thyristor. Okay, so triggering and commutation both are opposite words, ma, in power electronics. Triggering nothing but we are triggering the SCR by giving the firing angles, okay, like 0 degrees, 30 degrees, our requirement. Okay, so depending upon our requirement we are triggering on this SCR. Okay, so as SCR conducted and circuit or experiment is very well going on, so when we are if you want to turn off the thyristor, what we'll do by simply switching off the thyristor, switching off the circuit, thyristor will not switch off. Okay, because as we have in power electronics we have circuit turn off and device turn off, both terms are there, ma. So if you want to if circuit turn offs, sometimes time will take to turn off the device also. So that's why to turn off the thyristor we will take so much of the time. Okay, so forced commutation circuits nothing but we are turning off the thyristor forcefully. Okay, so we have two types of commutation circuits, ma, natural commutation circuits and forced commutation circuits. So natural commutation nothing but as when we at the time when we are giving the AC supply and when we are switching off the thyristor or turning off the thyristor, that is a natural commutation. Forced commutation circuits nothing but for when we are giving the DC supply. So at the time of DC supply means when we are giving the DC supply and when we want to turn off the thyristor forcefully, that is called the forced commutation circuits. Okay, so natural commutation is very easy, ma. By switching off the thyristor, first a circuit will turn off, again for a particular time device will be turn off, so totally circuit will be closed. But when we are giving the DC supply, it will take so much of time and so much of challenges will occur, ma. So that's why we have 5 types of commutations. So those are class A commutation, class B commutation, C and D, E. So nothing but class A means resonating load. Okay, so self commutation by resonating load. And next class B. Okay, next class C complementary commutation, class D auxiliary commutation, class C external commutation. So all are commutation circuits only, but by our requirement we have to choose which commutation we require as per our circuit diagram. Okay, so in this experiment we will see these 5 commutation circuits, ma. So apparatus required for this commutation, forced commutation unit, and resistive load RPS. Why RPS, ma? So in the earlier experiments, as we are using AC supply, we are using isolation transformer. In the isolation transformer we are giving 230 volts and we are stepping down to 30 volts, right? So here we are using DC supply. Already said, you know, forced commutation means DC supply, so that's why we are using regulated power supply. Okay, RPS. Next CRO. Okay, we'll see the circuits. See, this is a class A commutation circuit. See, here we are giving the 0 to 30 volts DC supply and thyristor T1, inductance, resistance and capacitance. Okay, and class B, ma. See, class B circuit, this is one. This is a class C commutation circuit. Okay, class D. Okay, next this is class E commutation circuit, ma. Okay, see, this is a theory, ma. Class A, class B, class C, D, E. Procedure, ma. Procedure is nothing but we have to connect the circuit diagram as per the connections. I'll explain how we have to see the circuit waveforms for A, B, C, D and E. Okay, now we will go to the class A experiment, ma, first. See, this is a class A experiment. See, as in the circuit diagram, from the voltmeter, I mean from the RPS, I'm giving the 2.5 volts, ma. simple normal just 2.5 volts. So here we are using thyristor 1 and LRC, right? So see, resistance and capacitance are in series and with respect to the load L, okay? C. And this is the connections. This is a forced commutation circuit, ma. Gate cathode, thyristor T1, capacitance, inductance, RPS. Okay, now we will see the connections, ma. So as per the circuit diagram, first this is a RPS, right? RPS positive and negative. RPS positive to positive, ma. Okay, RPS negative to negative. Okay, nothing but we are giving supply to the power circuit, DC supply. 2.5 volts A, positive positive to power circuit, power positive negative, positive negative. And after that thyristor anode to C, thyristor T1. Okay, so I already told you, here we are using only one thyristor. So only we are using only one thyristor. So as in the circuit diagram, from the positive of the from the positive of the one end of the voltmeter to thyristor T1, C. Supply one end to thyristor anode. Okay, next cathode to inductor one end. Okay, inductor another end to so there we have the RC one end short circuit and RC another two end short circuited, right? We are connecting, so I am connecting R to C, resistive load, and this is a capacitor, ma. C capacitor. Okay, so I am connected the R and C short circuited. See, R and R C one end, and R and R C another end. Okay, after we have to switch on the circuit, ma. Switch on the circuit and triggering and RPS. I already told you, ma, it's a 2.5 volts. I'm giving 2.5 volts and this is a waveform. See, this is a waveform, ma. Actually we are taking forced commutation is nothing but we are turning off the thyristor forcefully, right? So here I am connected CRO across capacitance or R, because they are both are in series, right? So I am connected CRO probe side across capacitive load. So at the capacitive load, when we are increasing the voltage, means when we are increasing the voltage, voltage will be stored at capacitance first. First, it will be stored at inductance part. Okay. So when I switch off the circuit, the storage which we the storage element, that is inductor and capacitor, will give the double of the supply. Means when we when I am given the supply to the inductor, it will store the energy, right? So at the same time, capacitor also will store the energy, okay, at that point we'll get only VS, source voltage is equal to capacitance voltage. But when I turn off the thyristor, when I turn off the thyristor at the same time supply, so what will get, what will happen, supply will stops, right? So gradually storage element inductance will discharges continuously. Okay, so at the time of storage, when inductance will gradually decreases, the total energy will be stored at capacitance, right? So when thyristor will when thyristor will switch it on, VS source voltage is equal to capacitance voltage. But when at the thyristor is turned off, source voltage is equal to double of the capacitance voltage, because the voltage will be stored at inductance also will come to the capacitance, right? So at the turning of the thyristor, capacitance will charges. So that's why here normally we see here we are getting the 4 volts. See, it increases, right? So normal 2.5, okay, that is source voltage. But at the time of the it's again decreases and is again increases ma. So at the time of switched on, capacitance will again increases, that is double of the source voltage, okay. Done.